we're going to do a market update now.
Awesome.
Now, the data that we have from the Massachusetts Association of Realtors is from April.
Yes.
And what's it say?
Well,
nobody sold anything. The houses, there was no inventory.
That was
a month ago. It's almost Memorial Day weekend. It's raining out. What's going on in the marketplace? Let's not go from the MAR charts that are dated.
Yeah. I don't do dated. I do tangible, real-life experiences.
Why use charts?
You use EKGs. I use my personal experiences. You love those. You can show them. I know you want to.
I don't have them loaded to show.
That's okay. They see there.
What I'm going to say is that the inventory in the marketplace now is high compared to post-COVID times.
Higher.
High. Well, no, it's high compared to post.
Yeah.
But it still is a shadow of what it was pre-COVID.
Right.
So the whole, there's no inventory in the marketplace. We're actually finding that there's stuff out there. And that people want to, if the house is on the market, they want to sell it.
Right.
And then the games begin.
Yes. We don't do games.
Of course we do. we do offers at what we think will acquire the property.
Make it happen. Yep.
We put contingencies in as sparsely as we have to.
Mostly take them all out.
Well,
that's what I
think. If someone has a mortgage and they need a mortgage contingency, I think it's silly not to leave it in there.
A million percent. Okay.
I happen to be someone that likes home inspections.
Okay.
Okay.
As a buyer agent?
I don't care.
Okay.
You know why? I know the conventional wisdom is, home inspection. No. If they've come in and they've gone through the house and they've inspected it, I don't want to hear later that they were surprised.
Right. Well, I've been doing something new, Gary.
What's that?
Okay, let me explain. So I'm noticing a lot of people feel that they need to waive home inspection.
Yep.
And when I'm a buyer's agent, I really readily advise to not do that. You know, I mean, you're making one of the biggest purchases of your life. Now you're going to say, I don't care what's going on in the house. So if they still aren't adamant that they want to do that, I offer them a home warranty.
Okay.
So we use American Home Shield warranty, literally covers everything. It's like $1,000 for the year. They've been great. You know what? I sold a house down the street. They've put 3 claims in and they've been covered every time.
Offline, we'll talk about someone that bought a house in the wintertime and American Home Shield didn't want to cover the air conditioning units.
Oi. So listen, insurance companies do not want to cover stuff.
Of course not.
You have to fight and advocate. I mean, you know, we talked about a car accident. Our insurance company doesn't want to cover it.
You know what I do?
What?
I get someone that is a knowledgeable person. I happen to have a friend that's a licensed Massachusetts building official. So
okay.
He is not a home inspector. He is a building inspector.
Yep.
And I have him go through the property like at a showing.
Which is great. Yeah.
And then I'm putting an offer in that doesn't need that they choose not to do a home inspection.
Yep.
Because he's already been there.
Which is great. I
got in trouble for it recently.
I'll let him go through.
No.
Oh.
No.
How?
This guy had done his homework.
Yeah.
And it said, this is marvelous that we're here, but this basement that clearly is finished was never permitted.
Oy.
Okay? So we told, should we disclose that? I'm in the mode of you always disclose.
CYA.
So what's
covering
it? Yes. It's I look at it more as informed.
Yeah.
You know, you're informing. And then the when it came time to do the PNS, this particular buyer was all into, well, the permits have to all be closed. Okay?
Yeah.
So I'm down with a particular town. You got to close these permits. They did.
Yeah.
But then they closed the permits for the work that was permitted. Let's remember that the entire lower level was not permitted.
Right.
So, whatever.
So, yeah, it's where we are at now. I am noticing, and I had 3 open houses, you know, last weekend, and tons of people threw multiple offers on all the properties. I think I had 2 home inspections, and probably 6 or 7 of the offers all waived appraisal or had huge appraisal gaps.
Yeah.
So, you know, I mean, it's people really need to be informed. I mean, I had one agent write appraisal waived, and I said, okay, so let's just...
Yeah, but the bank won't necessarily agree with that.
Let's just use a little scenario. What if this thing is $200,000 under appraisal? Well, you know, what are you going to do? Oh, well, I don't know. I'm like, but you can't say you're waiving appraisal if you're not prepared to take $200,000 out of your own pocket.
Right.
So, you know, buyers have to be informed as far as exactly what that means, and hence using a trusted real estate professional to guide you. I know one right here.
Yeah, so do I. Pretty good one, by the way.
It's important. You know, I mean, I see these offers and I read them. I'm like, this is not in the buyer's best interest. You know, and the whole appraisal waiver thing is just mind-blowing to me.
I understand an appraisal waiver if they're putting down like 50%.
Right. But when you have smaller down payments.
No, I agree.
Forget.
My point is, for everything that we can talk about, there's always that reasonable exception.
Right.
But you got to try to do the best you can to make sure that your people, your clients, are protected.
Right. Yeah. So it's, I mean, there's no shortage of buyers out there. That's for sure. I had two open houses in Shrewsbury. One on Sturbridge Circle, beautiful colonial, probably had 45 people through the door Saturday and Sunday. One on Grafton Street was great. We literally put it on Saturday afternoon. We had an open house Sunday. We had almost 20 people through the doors. And that's a short time frame to get a property on, market an open house, and 20 people, and then, you know, multiple offers on both properties. Knock on wood.
So one of the things that we've talked about in the past is staging. Oh. You're staging these houses.
Have you got? I am. So.
And my question to you is, do you perceive it's helping with the from the perspective of the buyers coming through, or do you think it's a lot of effort for what?
I think it's a lot of effort that has a good reward, because what happens is, you know, people are like, oh, people have asked, can I buy this? You know, especially if it's a completely vacant house, the house I had on Merriam Ave, completely vacant. You know, sometimes people don't understand how to lay out a space. So, you know, it's nice to see it look lived in. You know, people thought people live there. I'm like, oh, that's a compliment. No one lives here. It's been vacant for a year. But I think it helps people to visualize what you can do in different spaces.
Absolutely.
So, you know, I think it's well worth it. And I think it's just another service that we offer to help us, you know, stand above the rest.
All right. Parting comments.
Well, I'm looking forward to watching our first video. However, do not wait.
There was an incident before the video where there was a dog in a hot car. And let's just say Andrea was not going to rest for that to happen.
Yes, this video would not be happening if I didn't take care of business beforehand. My parting comments for this: do not wait for rates to drop. Now is the time to purchase. The minute we have any considerable drop in rates, it's going to be a feeding frenzy. Tons more buyers are going to come out. Housing prices are going to rise, and it's going to make it much harder to attain a property right now.
Agreed.
Thanks.
All right. Thanks, everyone. Have a great weekend.